Instagram and on YouTube. This is Ardak from Zen Art Supplies, and Beatrice here as well. So you don't see her, but you'll hear her for sure. And today we'll do some new kind of watercolor tutorials, and I'm still using our aspiring artist palettes, Sereno and Allegro. So these are two main, and maybe I'll use Espresso as well, because just want to show you that even with the student quality kind of watercolors, you can create some very stunning watercolor paintings. And today I want to make some kind of more airy and very much beautiful kind of foliage or florals. I want to try just to show you different techniques, and some of these very interesting techniques I saw from our current collaborators and collaborators in the past as well. So from Valentina, and her Instagram profile is Fantasvale. So she's a fantastic Valentina from Italy, so that you'll remember Fantasvale. And Beatrice will put her this hashtag also below this video as well, yeah, in the description, because she really has very beautiful kind of tutorials for aspiring artists, and she is our one of our brand ambassadors. Yes, she's really fantastic. And another inspirational kind of artist as well is our previously we were collaborating, and we're still friends with Natalia Nazarian. So her Instagram profile is Nata Nazarian. So she does a lot of very nice kind of video tutorials as well, and she does the illustrations to the books, so really beautiful. And you can also see her profile under the video. So if you really like this type of, just to check their profiles, but not only for this type, but also for many other kind of types of watercolors, and they really share lots of tips and tricks as well. So let's begin. I will make probably a couple of two or three, we'll see how it goes. So we'll start with something less complicated maybe. So it will be the ginkgo leaves that I saw from Natalia Nazarian's Instagram profile, and it's really, really cute. So I'll be using our watercolor paints and the paint brushes from our Black Tulip. Black Tulip watercolors kind of set. So this is synthetic brushes that are very popular, and you can see there are different kind of six brushes. Here there are only five, I don't know why. So it's just like one brush probably is, yeah, one brush, this large one, the flat one is outside of there. So six different brushes of very kind of various sizes, and yeah, you'll really love them. And also I'll use some of the brushes from our fine line detailing kind of set, and you can see that nice, and on top of the box you can also brushes there are. You can use these miniature brushes for not only for watercolors, but also for acrylics or gouache, even for oil, because oil, when you use this kind of for details, you really like. So I'll use some of these kind of brushes, and let's begin. So without further ado, be using some kind of very little sketchy type of drawing with my brush, but you can use also water soluble pencils normal pencil if you don't have water soluble pencils. Usually I would suggest a water soluble pencil because it will create additional kind of interesting
We actually have Valentina on the line.
Oh, really? Cool.
Just
hello, Valentina. Ciao, Valentina. I was talking about you. So we're going to. I'll try to show one of your kind of tutorials. I'll try to follow it. Yeah. So it's really nice to see you. And Beatrice will put your Instagram details under the video as well. So it's really nice to have you here as well. Beatrice, can you give me the? It's just there. Down. This one. Yeah. So I'm just sitting here and I'm a bit locked. That's why I always ask Beatrice to help me. Yeah. So I'm just, I bought this Neo Color water soluble. But you can use also, I also have this Kohinoor kind of water soluble pencils. They're also quite good. I bought it and I never used it, but I saw that these are the best for water soluble. Water soluble pencils or pastels. So let's start from our ginkgo, and I'll use the color that is similar. And I also saw that Valentina also uses. So Valentina is our brand ambassador, and she also uses this water soluble pencils or. Please correct me if I'm wrong for drawing, because it really just like additional kind of interesting kind of feature of your drawing that will also create this depth, I would say, instead of just like normal pencil. And you don't need to remove it. So, okay, let's start with this ginkgo leaves. So ginkgo leaves, they have this... this type of shape, so it's like heart, and it's yeah, so it looks like a fun as well, so you can few of them, and if there is someone from South Korea as well, so it's a national kind of symbol of South Korea, so there is a lot of ginkgo trees and a lot of ginkgo leaves on many South Korean kind of company branding as well. So just an interesting fact. I didn't know it before I visited Korea in the past. So, and it's a symbol of longevity because ginkgo is a it's a it has medicinal kind of properties as well. So just for an interest, I'll add another color as well. So Valentina, do you use the water soluble pencil? So I think it is.
Let's see what she says.
Just asking and then answering myself. Sorry for that. But that's what I do sometimes. And let's have maybe other two, maybe I don't know. Can make. Maybe 7, because 7 it's a good number as well in Asia, but so it's basically this kind of shape of semicircle, and then it has this. So I think 5 could be also good number, so not to overcomplicate and make it quick because otherwise. It will take forever.
Yes, by the way, Valentina, she uses them. Not always, but she does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's cool. Thank you. So... Good. Thank you, Valentina. We should have some lives probably with Valentina, not with me. Some of this kind of interesting techniques. And as soon as we'll receive our products of watercolors, it will be even more interesting maybe to hear your
feedback
yeah, and main kind of reactions maybe. So they are already in stock, but we just need to finalize with the listing, so then it will be available. So it's just like really not so long to wait for. So I'm using our Allegro watercolor set because it has, I'm just usually look at which colors are most kind of appropriate, and I use one or another. Of course, you can also mix these colors, but sometimes it's easier just to use the colors. So for this, I would put more kind of water. So just doing it. And I'm using our Catstone brush, and it's quite large, so you don't need to fiddle too much with something small for such kind of first round of color washes. And this was based on Natalia Nazarian tutorial, so I'll add more water, what she was doing. And then should probably add more additional kind of color on the sides. So I'll just use this olive color. And then you need just to remove it with the tissue. So very gently. Just completely removing in the middle. Should also look at the original kind of video tutorial, because don't trust me, but try it yourself and then also check. So this way it gives very much kind of translucent, and it also dries probably quite fast. So now I would go for the second one. So this time let's try to make a wet on wet technique. So it's probably it will be even better. Because at the very beginning I just started with wet on dry. When you put paint directly on paper, and it creates much more kind of saturated wash. Whereas if you want to make it very, very translucent, then I would suggest to use some more kind of wet on wet, because it's already kind of diluted with your water on paper as well. So
this was actually one of the questions, whether you should go wet on wet or wet on dry.
This is really what I'm just trying to show you, because I haven't done it before, and that's why I'm just experimenting with different techniques. And I think wet on wet is better, because it will really create this much more kind of airy type of wash. And you can see that it's much more kind of beautiful than this, I would say. Both of them, they're quite pretty, but still. You can also add a bit of yellow in the middle, because so the idea is really just to create this different type of Yes, Kala. Kala washes and you allow to Kala to go inside a bit, to set a little, just a little bit, and then try to remove it. Very gently, without creating some specific kind of shapes, you're removing this color, especially from the middle of the wash. This way, you're creating this much more kind of translucent and transparent transparency. So now, just to show maybe different brush, I'll use the round shape. So let's
you should be quite quick when doing this, when following this technique.
Yes, probably, because in general with watercolors you should be quick. So the timing of watercolor, it comes with practice. So you should practice, really. You should try different techniques, and you should look. Also, it depends on the paper, of course, because different paper, it works a different way. So that's why you should test it yourself and look at how, also the way how you mix the color. It all depends on your own kind of way of working, because I cannot just tell you. But the thing of using this kind of premixed colors that we have here is that it will not take you so long to mix the color, first of all. If you use much more kind of limited palette, then of course you also should consider the time of color mixing. And so you should really just do a lot of different sketches, this kind of works, just to play with the color, just to play with your brushes, to look at for which type of medium, which brushes are most suitable, and for which technique is most suitable, and all these kind of things. But it also depends on the paper, of course, because different paper reacts differently. So you'll see. So now I'm just adding this. Should have mixed it up. But now I can try to remove it. So just to keep it. Only in the middle. You're removing it. And you can also use some drying support kind of techniques. People use the hair dryer as well. I don't use it because I don't like the noise that it creates, but you can of course use it. The idea is just like to go through the this kind of different items in a way that they'll not, it will allow to dry, for example, before you start something else. So otherwise it will, I forgot. Okay, let's put the
color wash. So you should think about it also when doing the composition.
Yeah, yes.
If you don't want to wait.
Yes, if you don't want to wait, you can just like do what I'm doing. So I'm looking at which leaf, for example, is already almost dry, and I'll go there. So, because here, for example, there is a bit of puddle, and maybe I should remove it a bit. So, but when it's already starting to dry, if you'll start removing, you'll create quite a strong edge. So I wouldn't even touch it now. But this one, it's fine, because it's almost dry, and you can see that the stem doesn't is not affected at all by me doing something on this leaf that is just next door to it. And now I would add a bit more water, maybe just to remove it. If you want, you can add a bit of yellow as well, again, to the sides, just to create this interesting kind of effect. And we can reduce it again using the paper. So this is the way. I'm curious if you're painting with me or you're just watching. If you want, you can paint together with me, because I think it's
sure. Sometimes that, like, we also have people that just watch.
Mm-hmm.
Also sometimes someone told me they don't paint at all, they just uh-huh. enjoy watching people who paint.
Oh, okay. So it's a meditative kind mm-hmm. of process itself that you like. Yeah, me too. I sometimes like to watch first, and then when I paint. Don't. So this is the way how this watercolor pastels also dilutes, you can see. And let's add a bit more of this light green, which is better to not to do what I'm doing right now. So you should mix it on the, like this, so just like to mix it on the palette before applying it. So I'm not so good in watercolors, as I told you, because for me, when I started painting, watercolor was not so easy. So because you really need to plan it in advance, you really need to think in advance what you want to achieve, and keep the whites white as a paper. That's why it's quite difficult for me, probably. And it's more sort of negative painting, because not in a way of negative thinking, but it's you start from the light and you go and paint darkness, so the dark sides of the painting. So you try to keep as much empty the white spaces as possible. So that's why I'm calling it negative, because you paint where there should be dark kind of areas. And this way, it's just like you paint the shadows. So if you say it easy way. And that's why it was a little bit more kind of difficult for me just to think it in the opposite, because I understood that I prefer to paint from the dark to the light. So just to show where are the dark, and then just like lighten up everything. And this is really just like painting with oil, painting with gouache, or with, I don't know, acrylics as well. And watercolors is a little bit more kind of delicate. You really cannot overwork it and all these kind of things. But now I also enjoy it. So I'm really just like discovering watercolor again for myself. And to me, I felt like watercolor is the most difficult medium at the very beginning, especially because it's quite easy to mess up watercolors, just to overwork it. But maybe some people, they're really very good in watercolors. So you should try yourself all different mediums and see how you feel about it. Don't listen to anyone who says this is difficult, or like me.
And of course, let us know, those who are here, if you paint with watercolor, you're mm-hmm. just watching.
So I think that I will stop with this kind of, I'll not make a second kind of layer of wash, although you can do it as well. I'll start doing the details, because I think that's where I should start detailing. Although you can make a second layer as well of
Yes, they were asking if there's an alternative to water-soluble pastels for the outline. What would you use?
Yeah, you can use any watercolor pencils if you have them. So there are very small kind of sets of Kohinoor that I really love. It's the, I think it's Czech Republic kind of Kohinoor. It's very historical type of pencils. So they really just like do only pencils. And I remember that I had this set of water-soluble pencils since, I don't know, since my youth. They never just like finish. It's really very high quality, very highly pigmented, and you just buy a little set of few kind of most important colors, and you can use them for this kind of outlines as well. So, or you can use a normal pencil, but you should remove it first before starting painting on top, because otherwise you'll have these harsh kind of lines. And or maybe using the a bit harder pencil as well could work. So, but try to remove it not with just normal eraser, but this kneaded eraser, because kneaded eraser it will just collect the collect the carbon from the paper. It will not make any kind of damage to the paper itself. Yeah. So now I'm using our Rieger 4-0s from Zen Art Supplies, and it's really super thin, kind of super fine liner. And I'll use some of this, the same green probably that I was using. So. I'll use another green, maybe, just to make a slight difference.
Is it completely dry now?
Or? So yes, it's more or less dry, but on the sides it's a bit more kind of wet. So that's why I was just thinking to start with this, or maybe this is more dry. Yeah, you can just touch it, and also you can see it from the paper, because when it's wet, you can see a little bit of moisture. So. That's really difficult to explain when you do it, but you'll see it when on the paper itself. So here it will be all these little kind of lines. And you can just go on like this. Or you can also use the pencil as well. So if you have pencil. I'm doing it incorrectly, so it should go in the middle. But doesn't matter. So I can. So you can see that when you mix the color yourself, it will be much more vibrant as well. So I'm just mixing some yellow with viridian green, and do it very, very quickly, and in the middle it's a little bit thicker. So that's I'll just connect these lines to the ends, but so you can. Go like this. We can also alternate a bit the color shape a bit. Adding more yellow, for example. Alternate the thickness. So just hope you can see it. I'm using the rigger because it can hold more water. So you can see that you can make more lines with just one load of rigger than if I would use the very, very fine detail brush. And that's the difference of rigger to the normal kind of round brush. So for example, with this brush, which is round, and it's really, really tiny, you cannot do so many lines because it will not hold so much water, but it's much thinner and it will make very much kind of, it's very good for small details as well. And I really love riggers, so I don't know, maybe just. So if you
Yeah, usually people who have never tried a rigger before and they get even the black tulip, mm-hmm. they are very excited usually.
Yeah, riggers are my favorite, and that's why you'll see that in the, I think in every set that we have, there are riggers. So, don't make these lines super straight because it should be little bit regular. That's why I'm trying just to make a little bit wavy. Although with rigger you can create a super straight kind of lines as well. So they're very much they're very good for lining your paintings as well, for fine details. So of course, use some different shades of the for the lines as well. Just hope it's not very boring to watch these lines.
Oh, super exciting! Not exciting. It's relaxing. And
yeah, it is relaxing, especially for me. So with this ginkgo, try to make the, but it's with any leaf, I think. Just try to make them look like little veins as well, because these are really sort of blood vessels of the tree. So the, what I like of the this miniature brushes set is that it has very comfortable kind of handle, so you can hold these tiny brushes without any kind of hand fatigue, and your hands will not get so much tired like with if it was without this kind of handle. So let's start doing it a bit quicker. And
yes, and it's interesting to see how you're tracing them, because they can see the movement, whether you start from the top or the bottom. So sometimes if you only see the picture, you don't understand.
It's very interesting. Recently, I was just learning how to paint the trees. And in landscape. So maybe we'll do later some landscape kind of painting as well. But it's a bit more kind of advanced topic, that's why I don't put too much kind of difficult kind of complex topics as well, so not to just to go step by step, you know, just go from very simple kind of topics to more kind of difficult. But there is everywhere in nature and also in painting, there is this three steps or three layers. And also in the tree, for example, when you paint the tree, you start from the further kind of trees, and then you go closer and closer. So there are three kind of layers of the sky as well. So you don't paint them all with blue, for example. And there are three layers of the foliage of the tree, for example. So it's always from the very from the more kind of general, you go to the medium details and then to the frontal kind of details, what you want to see more kind of in detail. I don't know, I'm probably explaining strange way, but I want to learn it properly, and then I'll share it with you as well. So if you like some kind of if you want to learn about specific topics, please just let me know, because we're on this learning journey together, and it will be quite interesting. Soon, not soon, but now is already the weather is getting much better, so we'll be doing more kind of I'll be more plein air as well, so if you're interested, please let us know. Maybe if weather permits, we could do something from outside as well.
Could try, yeah.
We could try, yeah, because could do this live also outside. What do you think, guys?
Yeah, let us know.
Let us know, because this plein air painting, it's always fascinates me, because it's painting from nature, observing from nature. It's most important, I think, for any artist and for any human in general, because when and I think that it's also one of our kind of ideas is also of behind the brand is to popularize more kind of this plein air painting as well. Just that's why all our products are very much travel friendly and very compact. You can bring it anywhere, wherever you go with you. That's why there is this idea of this kind of self-containing kind of sets, and that because I really love traveling myself, and I really love when people just travel and paint whatever they like, for example, because I think it's this way you really bring your memories with you as well. In a more interesting way. So let me know if you do such kind of things.
Oh, and meanwhile, it's getting very nice. Overlap.
Yeah, I think you need another kind of layer, but just for the time being, we'll just do it this way. Maybe we'll do this some kind of revisiting this some of these topics and some of the some of the techniques, and then we'll also see some kind of lessons learned.
Yes, as usual, if you're trying to replicate this tutorial, always post with hashtag Zenart Supplies and hashtag Art with Ardak, so we can see your your version, if you give it a twist, or if you need any help, or you want feedback from us.
Yeah, that will be really great. Really love seeing some works that are done after the lives, because it's really cool just to see how useful it is it as well. Because whenever you see something interesting, try it yourself as well, because this way you will already learn through practice how to do something that you like, because it's one thing it's to admire things, but if you're really learning, immediately also practice. I'm not so great in practicing myself, but it's really it's also some kind of advice that I give to myself, just to not to procrastinate, you know. So this is the, you can also go with one layer over this as well, if you want, because this could be, I think, quite interesting if you even make it a bit softer. So I'll just paint these stems. And when they completely dry, you can also make another layer and it will completely just like bring everything together. So I'll just show you maybe on this one of the smallest. Because watercolor, what I like in watercolor, it's quite, it works very well with layers. I don't know what's up with my water. It's just like very strange water.
Shall we change?
Got something, yeah. It looks like it has some oil in it. I don't know. It's okay. I have another one. Maybe girls put something. So now I'm just putting some layer of and you can see that it brings it all together, I think. So what do you think?
People joining now, so sweet. Let us know what you think. Ginkgo leaves, yes.
Ginkgo, yeah.
Just joined. She's asking.
Yeah, Ginkgo is, I told before that it's a symbol of South Korea. So it's, in general, maybe it's a Korean culture altogether, because I'm not sure about North Korea, I've never been there, but I've been to South Korea, and there is everywhere, in all the parks, there are lots of ginkgo trees. It's really so beautiful. And they were telling that it has the heart shape, it has these medicinal properties, it's a tree that has this kind of, for the health and prosperity, so there are lots of good kind of symbols, and I really like ginkgo trees. They're quite beautiful. I think they're hypoallergenic, so that's why I like as well. So you can again just like remove a little bit of in the middle. So I think this one it's better, because it just like looks more kind of natural, isn't it?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
What do you think?
Yes, it's coming together, as you said.
Yeah.
It's,
so
yeah. So if you could just, they are asking, how do you make veins in the leaves? Because they just joined.
Yeah, veins on the leaves. So I first created this kind of outline with watercolor, water-soluble pastels. Then I did this first washes. And then when they dried, I went on top of them with our detailing brushes from fine line set. I'll show you in a second. Just want to keep going. So that's similar type of technique that I use. So I just can also just push all the pigment to the sides. That's what you can do as well with your brush. So you can use again this just wet brush, and if you want, you can go a little bit with slightly different type of color as well. So just on the very edges, just to create this contrast. So I'm using a little bit of kind of rusty red, English red.
They pop out beautifully.
Mm-hmm, thank you. So, and then you just remove excessive water in the middle, just to still keep it fresh and more transparent in the very middle. So that's and as I told at the very beginning, I saw this tutorial on Natalia Nazarian's Instagram profile, and after that I'll try to do what fantastic Valentina does. So her Instagram profile is Fantasvali, and she's our brand ambassador. She's really fantastic as well. So it's really cute. I like it. Don't need to do all of them. Maybe just like some of them you can keep more fresh. But
yeah, maybe the big one over there, you can keep it.
I'll keep this one like this, because it's my favorite. It was not overworked, you see. That's my problem. I usually overwork things. And now I'll just go with a bit of more yellow probably on top of this.
What do you think, guys? Have you ever tried ginkgo leaves or any other similar leaves, maybe?
Yeah, don't be shy. Share your experiences. So right now I'm using very loosely my Catstone from our Black Tulip mixed shapes, and previously I was using for this little kind of veins. I'll show you this just in a second. Our fine line detailing brushes. So it's quite beautifully presented set with this kind of unique this kind of pouch. So it's you can use it for keeping the brushes, and there is also this pouch that can hold any valuables. I don't know, maybe a few kind of your card, or I don't know, if you go for a trip. So you don't need to bring so much stuff, so you can just keep it here as well. And usually thieves will not think that you'll keep anything valuable in your brush set. That was my kind of idea. And then it's really nice. And so like this. So this is ginkgo leaves, and I think it's quite nice. So,
please give it to me. I think they are referring about the brushes.
Okay. So, I thought that they like my ginkgo leaves.
I like your leaves. No, but they were also asking questions and they like it.
Thank you. Now I'll do very quick, I'll try to make it quicker than ginkgo leaves, the leaves by Fantasvali. So Valentina, she's our brand ambassador, and better to check her profile as well. And Beatrice will put all the profiles of Natalia Nazarian and of Valentina under this video, as we told already, and check their videos. It's quite nice, and they have lots of kind of educational kind of tutorials as well. So now let's go. So Fantasvali does very cool kind of leaves that you need this kind of craft knife for it, and I'll just probably make couple of these leaves, or three leaves maybe. Yeah, three is a magical number.
Lots of likes and hearts coming.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. So for that I'll use this where is it? Let's use this olive carandash again. So it's Neocala Corel water soluble wax pastel. So I'll use just to make a simple kind of leaf shapes that are quite over exaggerated, I would say. Yeah, so they would just go probably in different directions as well. And that's so you can see also this tutorial on Fantasvali's account. It's really, really beautiful. I'm not sure that if I'll do it like her, but I'll try. So let's make these shapes, and of course this so you make it quite loose and not too much detailed, because this way it will keep freshness. And I would also suggest you not to move your sheet of paper, because this way you will also train your brain to draw upside down, and it's really cool, because it's part of this interesting kind of technique of drawing with your right half of brain or left half, I don't know. So it's just like to think quite differently, not too much kind of concentrating on what you're drawing, but doing it much more loosely and more intuitively. So now we'll use this craft knife. Please be careful with it. So it's very, very sharp, and I saw that they're sold everywhere, so in all the stationery shops. Yeah, otherwise you can also use a normal kind of stationery knife probably. But this is much more easy, you know, to hold. So and for this technique you just follow the lines that you just done. And it's almost like scratching the paper, and just do it also quite loose. And maybe you should do it more kind of methodically, so that you'll not forget where did you cut it, because I don't see where I cut. So starting from the veins at the bottom, just to go up. And so never done this as well. Try to do this as graffito using my palette knife. So if you don't have any knife, try palette knife as well. It will be much thicker, of course, the line. So for example, lines in between, maybe for the veins in between, I'll use the palette knife. So, but with palette knife as well, you can do it. So it will not be as easy as with your normal knife, but still possible. So try it as well. I'll go back to my scalpel. Let's pretend that I'm a surgeon for a bit. Yeah, my brother-in-law, he used to be a surgeon, now he has a business, and if he'll hear me, he'll be a bit pissed off. Because he's very much, he doesn't like when someone speaks about doctors without any, without the proper respect. No, I really respect the doctors and the heroes of all the time, because they really do fantastic work to save lives and to keep us all healthy. So it's no way it's, I was trying to offend any surgeons by pretending to be a surgeon with my leaves. It's just a joke.
No, thank you for clarifying. I think that was clear that you were not offending, but it's always good. Yeah. It's always good to clarify.
Yeah.
So they are asking if you're not following exactly the lines you trace, but you're adding
sort of. Yeah. So these lines, they are just for your kind of for an idea, so that if you don't like it, for example, you could do it differently, and so it's more or less the same, but I wouldn't go very much perfectly on the exactly the same shapes, because it will be much more difficult, because your knife is not a pastel or pencil, but it's less kind of, it has its own kind of shape lines. But you can try like this. Try it. You'll see that what I mean, because you'll not be able to to repeat exactly the shapes. Keep it away from children and pets, and from yourself, maybe, just not to get injured accidentally. So I always keep it closed, and I keep it away. I don't keep it on my desk usually. I don't know what's up with my water. It's all dirty, but it's okay. So now let's go ahead and we'll do some. We'll make a wash now. So I'll use the other palette. I'll use Sereno, because that's the sort of similar colors that Valentina was using. So. And I'll use just similar colors or slightly different. So I'm not trying to replicate exactly, so that's why. But as you know, probably from previous videos, Sereno has more kind of the cool colors, and there are many of these very beautiful blues and purples. And I want to use this mint green probably at the very beginning, or aqua blue, so just mix them together, and I still have some yellow on my, but it's fine on my brush. So you can do the, you can wet the, you see, that's so cool, because it has this olive water soluble pastels, and that's why to already make this olive kind of wash, even just with water. So you can stretch your paper as well, of course, but my paper is not stretched, and I'll use just a clip, paper clip, Guys, look at this. Look at what it's doing. My goodness. So we're also coming with some very cool watercolor paper products, but right now I'm not using it because I don't want to spoil surprise, which I'm already doing, but it's okay. So just using some of this. What's up? There is some black that I got. Maybe it's from the palette, yeah. I'm using. And you can also do some mix different colors. So it's you can use one color, or you can make this graded washes. So actually, for such kind of large washes, probably it's more appropriate to use the large flat brush. It's just me. I forget to use different brushes, but you should to use. Yeah, I have purple. It's purple brush. Didn't wash it, sorry. So, but it's not a problem.
But no, but it's, look at that.
Yeah, it's just there.
Popping out now.
So that's there. So now you can see where I was making the cuts. Because the olive green, it's already kind of starting to get diluted, yeah, with all the water that I added. And now you can see exactly, I'll be adding a bit more color now. So I'll add probably some slightly stronger blue. I'm doing this not exactly like Fantasvale, so because I'm very much impatient person, but what she was showing, she was waiting that it will dry completely. So I'm just doing this graduated washes a bit. So that's what I'm doing. And this way. She was making layers, but I can do it this way for now. So at least one. And maybe I'll add some other kind of colors, some violet. Let's use it for this flower, for this leaf. Mine will be very much kind of free adaptation to add your own kind of touches to any tutorial that you like. This way you not copy everything, you know, but just put a lot of your own kind of personality in it. And that's the whole idea, I think, of doing tutorials. So just use the method, the technique. Maybe you can also use the same kind of subject, but of course it will come out differently because it's quite difficult to copy exactly. And my idea is not to copy, but just to show you what my take is from this interesting tutorial. So and this one, let's make it green. We'll use some kind of emerald green, and so it's already now I can see the dot lines as well that I was making, and just have a little bit of just very light kind of time difference between you start adding new color. This way the previous color will already be inside of the paper. So the pigment usually just sinks in the color and or in the paper, and this way you can create this kind of soft washes mm-hmm. and without diluting completely the previous color as well. What do you think, Petrich?
Mm-hmm. I like the color combination. Yeah.
I think it's my favorite kind of colors.
Cool colors, yeah. This eerie effect is still there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So now you can see that this side it's already getting dry, and you can see it from the sort of luminosity of the paper, because when it's completely wet, it's very very kind of how to say. It sparkles, so the water reflects completely. When it gets more dry, it becomes more and more matte. So this is quite nice, just to add some more color as well. This one will already create more kind of layer, so this more like a dry layer here, because it's, and you can also touch. So here it's much drier than here, and you can also see it. So the more you do this kind of washes and different, you'll just like experiment with the timing, with different type of paper as well. So the more you'll be more kind of, it will be much easier to apply all these kind of techniques. So now maybe we can add more to this blue one. Of course, the best one will be, the best effect will be if you completely just wait it when it will dry.
But we also have limitations for the live, so.
Yeah. That's why I don't usually wait, and I don't want to make all this noise, you know, with the hair dryer. So at home you can use the hair dryer to dry. So as I told you, that in watercolors you add layers, and with each layer the color will be stronger. So the layers, they just like very much translucent, and they add up the color. So you build up the color with layers. So
with this take, I think we'll have to close Instagram for mm-hmm. today.
Yeah, and you'll see the final result also on Instagram.
On Instagram,
and you can watch it. Yeah.
And you can watch it on YouTube, the continuation. We'll put the link mm-hmm. now in stories.
Yes, thank you for being with us on Instagram, and see you next time. Please let me know if you like it or you don't like it. It'll be really interesting just to get some feedback. If you follow these tutorials, please tag us, and it'll be quite interesting to see your leaves.
Yes, yeah. Look at that. I leave you with this beautiful color, so you have to come over to YouTube.
Yeah.
See the continuation.
Yeah, come to YouTube.
Okay. Okay. Bye, guys.
Bye bye. So, for those who are on YouTube, I just continuing this beautiful leaves, and you can already see where were the cuts, and until it will dry completely, it will also just make it much more stronger kind of this color, color of this kind of cuts. So you'll see it even more kind of profound. You can also use maybe some of the Riggers. So I'll just to accentuate the so I'll just use a bit of some blue. So I'm using the ультрамарин блю. And while it's still wet, it will be very, very soft kind of. There'll be soft lines that will be almost sorry, when I paint, it's quite difficult for me to talk, but you can see. I'm just alternating different blues. It will be very soft transitions, that's what I was trying to say. So you can use also some clean paper, clean water as well, if you want to create some effects. You can also just push a bit with your brush some paint on the paper already that is already there. And of course, just alternate different type of blue. It's a bit of even a bit of dry brush kind of effect here. Very pretty. Yeah, like this. So you can also ask any questions while you're here on the. Maybe it's not the best kind of what I've done, so you can also always adjust it with a little bit of. Just a bit of water. Maybe I don't like so much this strong kind of lines of with color, so I just used another wash to soften it completely. Yeah, this is much better, I think. So your brush strokes should also go in line with the shapes that you're painting, and this way you'll just make a very nice flow of so now we can just add a bit of color here as well, and I think that will be it probably. Maybe not so strong like this, but it's okay. So you can also just use it to stretch without adding any additional pigment. Like this. I think it's quite nice. So if you leave it to dry like this, you can also use some other colors to in this kind of areas, and maybe a lot the same kind of this aqua green, maybe with some little pattern if you want.
So Ardak, we have someone who just joined on YouTube and they're asking if you could just go over quickly through what you've done so far.
So I was I was inspired by Fantasvali's video tutorial on Instagram. So she, it was a, this short video where she was showing this type of leaves. So how she did it, and I just try to do something similar, which is completely different, I would say. But I really liked the whole idea of this sort of graffito kind of technique. So I first made a drawing, kind of very light drawing, using the just normal kind of watercolor, water-soluble pastels. So I used Grandache in my case. But you can use just normal pencil or colored pencil or watercolor pencil. And then I used this this kind of, how is it called? This kind of knife. Yeah, it's like a scalpel knife, yeah. So just to cut out all these kind of shapes of the leaf. So it doesn't have to be exact. Kind of going on top of the drawing, but can be something similar. So and then I started with one wash of this kind of this aqua blue kind of together with mint green color from our new Sirena watercolors for aspiring artists. And then I started adding kind of more layers on top, so different, using different colors. And I also was mentioning that I mentioned that Valentina, she didn't do what I'm doing right now, so she waited and she did the proper layer on the dry kind of wash. But because of the time limitation and because I don't like this noise of the of the hair dryer, I don't usually use it. So we're just like doing some kind of washes on top of slightly dry or still wet kind of. So here you can see that it's still wet, wet on wet. Here wet on dry, wet on semi-dry kind of. So it's just different layers, and you can see that all these cutouts. Not cutouts, cuts on the paper, they just absorb more, attract more of the pigment, and they trap them here, so you can see very, very fine lines here. So paper just making this kind of graffito in Italian, and so you can also use it in colors for creating this effect. And frankly speaking, it will make even more kind of contrasting effect once it dries. So that's what I'm doing, and I hope you can try it as well. So I'm using our watercolor brushes as well, that Valentina also loves. She really made such a good kind of honest opinion review. Yeah, it you can also watch it if you understand Italian, or you can just watch what's on her Instagram and YouTube.
Yeah, so speed paintings without any voice.
With speed painting, it's really fantastic. So her, she's our brand ambassador, Valentina, and her Nick on the Instagram and YouTube, it's Fantasvali. So you can remember Fantastic Valentina, it's Fantasvali. This is how I immediately remembered her.
So they are thanking you for reminding what you've done so far. So the paint will settle into the scratches. Got it?
Yeah.
Thank you so much, it's so beautiful.
So this is another one that we've done before. So, and here I was using a different technique. It's an art supplies fine detail, detailing brushes. So all these veins, I was for the veins, I was using the riggers, and they're really very good for different mediums. And where we use the same hair, synthetic hair, just exactly the same like in our black tulip series. So it's exactly the same kind of beautiful black synthetic that imitates a mix of squirrel and sable performance. Shapes and sizes, so you can really paint a lot. You know, these are not this all of them, so I'll just show you all. Yeah, so there is this very large flat brush, Catstone, round 8, where is the other? Yeah, round 10. Another flat that is much smaller, 8, and the rigger. So this is the beautiful rigger that I was using. So you can see these brushes are really amazing. Gouache for the liquid acrylic paint, and you can also use it for alcohol inks or some other inks, water soluble inks. They're really very nice. They're very much they absorb a lot of water, they release water quite nicely, so you see they don't drip. And the rigger brush, it's super pointy, you can see it. Yeah, they're all very pointy, so that's the brushes, because even this brush, which was dry and was a little bit fluffy, so when you wet it just a little bit, it gets back to its original shape, and you can see that it can create very fine lines. So I'll just show you here, for example.
So I've seen those brushes on another profile, Mind of Watercolor, and they look very nice. I need those in my life.
Yes, yeah, that's nice. So you can use these brushes also for creating some feather effects when they're more dry, this kind of animal hair or grass kind of, you know, it's very, very nice kind of brushes, very versatile. And when they're wet, they're really perfect for large washes as well. So this Catstone, it's one of my favorite brushes. It's all of them, they're my favorite brushes. It's just 6 brushes, really. So the Catstone, it's really great for painting any subject, I would say. So it's especially for florals and foliage leaves, they're really good. So it's very, very, very fine point. And on the sides as well, you can make some very straight lines. So it can absorb a lot of water as well. So the round brushes I was showing you, that they're both super pointy, the rigger as well, so they're very, very pointy. This one it's not been used, but I'll show you.
Yeah, Catstone for leaves is amazing.
So you can see that it's super super pointy, all the brushes, and also the flat brush, number 8, it's really useful, especially if you paint something architectural, so where you really need to put some straight lines, some shades. I don't know, it's really amazing as well, and you can see how thin is it on the very edge, and it has all brushes, they have full belly and very good kind of straight edge, so very, very fine, you can see it. It's quite important because they also keep shape for a very long time, and I wanted to show you that you can consider our fine line set, which has even more brushes, so it's 12 brushes. So of the I think it's like this here, can you see it? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Yeah, 12 brushes of different shapes, so there are 4 rounds, from very tiny one to quite good size, you know, that, like this. Oh, no, not this. Okay, I'm showing some different brushes now. So I was using them for oil. So what I do, because these brushes are quite universal, especially this fine line, I use some of the brushes, the larger ones, for oil painting, and the very thin ones and riggers, especially, I use for watercolors. Or I just have just this largest rigger for oil as well, because they really can hold a lot of water and paint as well. So the brushes themselves are very, very good kind of, they have unique hair that you cannot find with our other suppliers. So we have this hair, it's quite unique, so you don't find it somewhere else. And it really holds very well water, the pigment. It's quite snappy and springy, so and the most important, you see, it just like keeps the shape very well. I can do like this, and it keeps the shape still. So
yeah, Aurora is saying, oh, this is my next set of brushes.
Yeah, thank you. It's really good, because I just want to make even the whole kind of tutorial only using the fine line brushes, because some people might think that they are the same like other cheaper brushes, but they're not the same. They're much better. The quality is really fantastic. And I can tell you, because I do all the sets according to my own taste, and I test them a lot. So and they are very, very good quality, really much higher quality than anything that you can find cheaper, I would say. So don't be fooled by the appearance, but you should really test. And for all our brushes, for example, we give the 1 year warranty, so don't be afraid of buying and trying, and because these are really fantastic brushes, they'll serve you for a very long time.
And just to add on this, mm-hmm. to everybody who is watching, you see this pinned comment on YouTube, you can mm-hmm. register there for offers or initiatives that we are launching. So mm-hmm. see this pinned comment on the chat section where you are typing right now, mm-hmm. so you can be informed about mm-hmm. all our challenges or new content coming mm-hmm. out, new mm-hmm. lives. So mm-hmm.
yeah, that's really good way to keep in touch with us. And yeah, I also want to show you very quickly our latest watercolors that I was using. So this espresso, it's 12 most essential colors, and they all come with this kind of paper that you can use for making your own color swatches, just to remember which color looks how. So here you can see exactly, for example, even from the colors themselves, but sometimes especially and here you can see that there are all the major colors. And for example, if you need warm red, you can mix crimson with orange, it will become very kind of nice warm red. That's the only color that is missing here, but that's why I added orange. But all the rest, they're really, there are lots of nice blues, which is quite important, I would say. There are different yellows and oranges, and of course this neutral kind of rhombus. You can really paint anything with this paint set. And I especially want to show you, because it's very nice weather now, and you can use this paint set for just keeping it in your pocket and together with a sketchbook and paint everywhere. Because I really love sketching, and this espresso is really for your kind of sketching. Then there are the other two main palettes. The Sereno with lots of colors of the cool kind of side. And of course, there are all the main kind of primary colors that you can, you'll not miss anything here. And here it's quite important to have this color swatch, because Some of the colors you don't see them, which color is it, because they all may look the same, but using the color swatch, you'll know exactly which shade is it and which color is it. And so the names are already printed, so it's quite easy for you as well. There is a color splash kind of protection, so you can put it on top like this. And there are two brushes. One is just a normal kind of synthetic flat brush, which is also quite nice. And another one is, I'll show you. So it's this type of barrel brush, but I don't see what I'm doing. Now I can see myself. Okay. So, but I added here black ink, for example. So you can also do black ink, or you can just use it empty with white, just normal water. Sorry, not white water, transparent water. But I like that you can also do the use the black ink, because it's something that it's quite useful. The other one, the other palette, it's very much kind of Allegro. It's all the warm colors, and it's very good for the florals. And you can see these colors are here, all of them. There is also very useful kind of thing, like this sponge, so to control the water on your brush and for cleaning your barrel brush. So here it's just a normal kind of empty barrel brush that you can fill with water, and whenever you need, so you can just like mix your colors here, and then you can also clean it here with
my shopping list is getting longer.
Yeah, there is also another one that is we added this kind of splash protection kind of, because just in case if you're somewhere painting outside and you need to quickly just like close everything up, and you don't want to make a mess, so you just clean it here, all these paints, you put this splash protection and just close it, so it will not make a mess around. So the last but not least, I want to show you this. This is another kind of set that it's Prezioso, and we already did a mini kind of tutorial, which was on the leaves, and I was painting these leaves on the black paper. And it's about the this collection of the metallic paints, and they're all based on mica, and they're very much kind of, you can see they're super translucent and very sparkly. Yeah, and all the names are very interesting, so you'll feel yourself like an alchemist that plays with some metals and minerals. So, and they're really beautiful on white, and even more interesting on the toned paper, like black paper or some gray paper or anything. So you can paint with them, or you can just add to your normal kind of watercolors, and just for additional kind of interesting effects. So
Nat thought of everything.
Yes, thank you. So here every set, it comes with such kind of guide. So the whole idea is really just like to flow your follow your creative flow, and paint with colors of your mood. And there is this Venice, which is, for me, it's the most beautiful kind of and water-based city in the world. And they are very much kind of colorful. And there are lots of reflections of all these colors of the buildings in the water. That's why there was this idea of putting Venetian masks as well on the sets. And you can see them also, just to remind yourself which set are you using. So there is also this Venetian kind of clock on San Marco, and these are all the colors of the four sets. So just in case if you buy one, you can always see which colors are in the other sets, and you can also read what was the thinking behind it. So here I added this espresso, that it's really on the go, quick sketches, and our sketchbook as well, so you can do some sketches and drink coffee at the same time. Because the set is so small that you can do lots of stuff. And the colors, so for example, these are colors on white paper, and here Prezioso, I made this kind of color swatches on white and on black paper, so you can see the difference, what kind of effect on the black. So and, for example, bronze, you can see exactly how much brighter the bronze color is on the black paper, for example. Some other colors, they are a little bit, you really need to see it in life, but here you can see just some kind of representation. But in life, of course, these metallic paints are much more beautiful. So I hope that, and here, of course, there are other kind of products that we were talking about. There is, of course, Turner collection, that is the full set of the watercolor watercolor brushes, and with palette knife, and with a beautiful this satin case, and so fine line miniature, our bestseller Black Tulip. And also soon we'll make additional kind of pre-launch kind of videos about our new cotton paper for artists and new professional artists watercolor palettes that are much more compact, but also very high quality and professional kind of quality watercolor paints. You can see everything on our newly designed website, zenartsupplies.co, and there is a lot of information about our products. Ah, this is me painting in the past, so that's how I used to paint. I lost a little bit, but this is a watercolor with ink. So later maybe we'll show also some more kind of advanced tutorials using different mediums, so it's more with ink, and maybe later we'll do also with acrylics, watercolor with gouache, I don't know, so all these different type of watercolor on canvas. So whatever you really you're interested, please let us know. I'm always quite open to test and to try different techniques, to come back to some techniques that I used to do in the past as well. So please don't be shy, and we always listen. Okay, thank you very much for your time, and see you next time. Bye-bye. Just switch it off now.